Madden territory. Tell your mama and tell your daddy. Tell the whole damn world this is Madden territory. Come get some if you want some. But you ain't bad enough, so you can't take none. I'm Big Snoop Dogg, and I'm the only one. And when it comes to Madden, all y'all fools my sons. Ha ha, bag up off me and watch it lose. Snoop Dogg is on the mic, I'm giving Madden blues. And if you choose to run up on me, you gon' get laid out so fast. Cause I can get you with the run or I can hit you with the pass. Touched and I can't be schemed. Roll your when I'm in a mud league. 2-0, 2-0. Madden time on you suckers. Y'all can't get close, so why you wanna touch us? Cause my team.
Now we're cooking. I'm Jonathan Coachman. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Coming up, running back Dalvin Cook. He's back and coming off a big game a weekend ago, as it'll be the Minnesota Vikings taking on the New York Giants. I'll have scores around the league for you at the half. But it's time for a little football. So we'll hand it over to our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, we welcome everybody to the Garden State. EA Sports coverage of the NFL finds us at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Minnesota Vikings and the New York Giants. Alongside my partner Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you take a look at this Giants ball club. They've certainly found their groove of late, winners of 5 in a row.
And I think the sky's the limit for this team. They're playing the best football that they've played in a long time.
Meanwhile, for our visitors, the Vikings, they come in after tasting defeat for the first time in about a month as their loss snapped a 4-game winning streak. The shadow's starting to get a bit longer. Week 10 of the NFL season is here, and we're underway on EA Sports. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. So here are the Giants ready to start their initial drive of the game. And they'll be led out by the man running the show, Charles, their quarterback.
And what's a quarterback's best friend?
Balance?
I think you're right. I agree with you. You know, a lot of guys would say great receiver, right? A terrific offensive line. But I agree with you, balance, because if you can run the ball effectively, that just opens things up for guys who want to throw it and gives you easier passing lanes and easier coverages to read.
And they said balance will be a focus in this one.
Yeah, they don't want it all just heaped on his shoulders, I don't believe. I think they want to make sure they take some of the pressure off.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. And the offensive starters for the New York Giants.
And this team is coming in off of their open week. And to me, a pretty good time to have it, too, because it's pretty much right in the middle of the season. So I would think that they'll be pretty well rested and ready to go for the second half of the season. But even more importantly, they got a little bit of a mental break as well. That's going to help, too.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 13 yards, good for a Giant first down. On the ground, this is Saquon Barkley. But not before getting this inside the 30. It's a gain of 34.
That outside handoff to the left, that play has to warm the heart of an offensive line coach, because they controlled the left side where they were supposed to, but they didn't allow anything to leak from the backside on the right side of the offensive line either. Well played.
Yeah, and it created a big run. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Now Saquon Barkley. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Time for a look at our starters here on defense. Now they're going to be tough to throw on, no doubt. Currently ranked third in the NFL against the pass.
And when you're getting ready to face the number one overall offense in the NFL, it does not matter where you rank defensively because you got your hands full. You don't know what you're going to face, but you know that that's a strong unit that you're getting ready for. Come off the ball.
Here's a 2nd and 7. And nearly an interception here on their opening drive. But instead, 3rd down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. Well, they're piecing together a nice drive to start this one. Seems pretty scripted and pretty successful so far.
And I think they did it without our help. Because you remember when we sat in the production meeting with them to talk about this, and hey, you know, how you guys going to come out of the gate? I know I offered my help with a few plays, and they didn't seem to want it.
I didn't offer mine.
You know, you were the smart one. Whatever they're doing, though, it's working really well.
Barkley will try to punch it in. And he is in. Touchdown, New York. Touchdown. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Giants take it right down and score on the opening drive. This crew, they were on a roll going into the bye week that they just had, Charles, so sort of picking up where they left off.
And you and I both know that when you come back off of an open week and you've been winning games, you should get a few extra days off in order to recharge and refuel. But coaches often hedge their bets, too. They'll bring them back and work them really hard that first practice back to make sure that they're back and grounded.
Whatever they did, formula looking good so far in this one. Extra point right down the middle, and it's now a 7-0 game. So this drive spans 7 plays, and it's capped off by a touchdown run from Saquon Barkley. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So here's the Viking offense making their way out. They'll be led out by their quarterback, who grew up just outside of Cleveland on Lake Erie, Mitchell Trubisky.
Okay, I thought there was something to build on in last week's game by his performance. I thought he played fairly well overall. The numbers won't knock your socks off. 2 touchdown passes and an interception. The bottom line, though, they lost.
Yeah.
How does he eliminate that one interception, continue to take care of the ball, and maybe increase the number of times he puts the ball in the end zone with a receiver?
And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. Call it a gain of 4 on 1st, and that'll make it 2nd down. Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. Switch. Give to Cook out of the gun. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. He'll get 15 and a Vikings 1st down. Couple of very nice carries to start this drive out.
Yeah, 2 1st downs. And how about that 2nd one? What a nice run on that particular play. I'm telling you, they're going to start to think that this game is easy if they continue to rip off yardage like this.
Following the good run by Cook, here's another 1st and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. Time to look at the defensive starters for the New York Giants. They're going to need to be strong against the run in this one.
I jotted down in my notes in prepping for this game that this is definitely an area we got to keep an eye on, because you talk about where they rank in stopping the run, but how about what they're facing? This unit loves to run the football, and they rank highly in the league in getting it done.
Yeah, power against power. Something's got to give. On 2nd and 9, Trubisky. And this is Cook with a grab. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. 10 yards, and it's good for a Viking first down. So the drive takes him into Giants territory now. First and 10 at the 45-yard line. Open man is born. It's a gain of 11 as the Vikings pick up the first. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. From the shotgun is Trubisky. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. A gain of 6 there on first.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, we've got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. 7 yards there and a first down. On first and 10, it's Trubisky. That'll be complete to Cook. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. Give him 6 on the play, and that'll make it second down. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. First carry for the Boise State Bronco, Alexander Madison. And he'll take this one down near the 15. Just a gain of a yard there, and now will be third down. This will be play number 9 of the drive here as they need 4 yards on third down. Throwing here, Trubisky. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. It'll be a pickup of just 2, and that's going to make it fourth down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, partner, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. So I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting 3? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find ones that get you into the end zone and get you 6?
This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And here comes the Giants offense back out onto the field. And Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a 2-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs, so they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them. On second down, here's Barkley. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31. Now we've got a Giant player here slow to get up after that last play. We'll get an update when we return to MetLife Stadium. An extra defender in the secondary for the Vikings here on third down. He'll drop to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Dontari Poe marches in for the sack.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and they can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
Fourth down, so on is the punter, Riley Dixon. Fielded at the 20. And when it's said and done, it's a 58-yard punt. And the Vikings will take over here, first and 10. And out now come the Vikings. And, you know, certainly a lot of football left to be played. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're first place in their division, looking good, looking to be a threat come January.
And let's think about what every team has in their goals, all right? Number one goal is what? Make the playoffs. Number two goal is win your division. Number three goal, and the biggest goal, I think, is to be the highest seed possible that you can be heading into the playoffs so that you can have as many home games as possible to try and get you to the Super Bowl.
And right now, fighting for every win possible to try to at least secure home field for the wild card and or divisional round. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Let's make these babies cry all the way back home.
Brings up second and nine. Let's make these babies
And that'll be incomplete. You and I watched film yesterday, and you told me to watch his feet. For whatever reason, his footwork just looked off on that throw.
And you always love it when an ex-defensive back talks quarterback mechanics, right?
Well, but you're good at it. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. O'Shane Zimenez in there to get him, and that is sack number six now for him on the year.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. Fielded just inside the 30. It's a four-yard return following a punt of 49. And it'll be Giant football first and 10. And New York set to take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
They'll put a check mark in the box where the defense coordinator was saying, how well can we stay with these receivers if we're in man coverage? Because he just did it on that one. Force the incompletion. That'll allow him to get bolder with his pass rush, won't it?
Absolutely. Frees up your guys elsewhere. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Back to throw. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. Here's Riley Dixon now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the four and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked
so
well.
Else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
From the 22, here's second and eight. Now a run with Cook. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up third down. That was shades of Tennessee Volunteer football back in the 80s with Charles Davis coming up from the secondary to make the tackle for a loss.
You mean my teammates doing that, right? Because they would tell you, my coach would say, where's that tape? I want to see that. But how about the complete package there? Not just playing the pass, but being a willing tackler and making a really nice play.
On third down, Trubisky. And that is incomplete.
They went with the dime look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
The Vikings send out their punter as he'll kick it away for the second time. That's pulled in at the 32. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Here's the Giant offense now making their way back out onto the field. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and give these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. On first down, Laird. And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
And he's got it across the midfield stripe and into Viking territory. Out of the gun now on third down. He'll complete this to Ingram as tight end. 50 catches for him now on the year, and he's got a first down.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. And to give this time to the tailback. Tackle made that time by Anthony Barr.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
And he'll get three down to the 34-yard line.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings' 15-yard line.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
That time and another first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, last drive they went three and out.
They'll come out in the pistol.
Bring it! Bring it!
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he is in! Touchdown, Giants! A great play there with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Giants are able to add on to their lead.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
No problem there on the extra point. And that pushes the lead up to 11. So that drive takes him down the field in 8 plays. And it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota. And with this deficit, You can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
They'll come up now second and four from the 31. They run, Cook. And tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. Five in the secondary now for the Giants here on third. From the gun, it's Trubisky. And he's able to find Diggs.
Let's go, Trubisky.
We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
A 10th carry in the game for Cook. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. On second down, it's Cook. Taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. It's a gain of 11 as the Vikings pick up the first. So the drive takes him into Giants territory now, first and 10 at the 45-yard line. After one, a 14-3 ball game. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
Guys, stay in situation. Let's go.
On the carry, it's Cook. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. They go play action with Trubisky. And he's going to go down. Back near midfield at the 49. That's sacked by Khalil Mack.
Enough takes to start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Let's see what they draw up here. Third and long following the sack of Trubisky. Out of the gun, Trubisky. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
And based on my math, they've only converted one time thus far in this game. So you can see the frustration starting to come out a little bit. Third downs, they've been a problem for them all game. They've got to start becoming solutions.
The Vikings send out their punter as he's on to kick it away. And he gets this away. And look at this. This is a good one. The Giants offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. That last drive, it was a good mix. Run, pass, run, pass. Defense on their toes.
And what really helps out in a big way is when you're doing the run, pass, mix and everything's working, that means that they're guessing wrong every time on defense. They think you're going to pass when you run and vice versa. I would continue that, and when they finally draw a bead on you, maybe you mix it up a little bit, a little play action, and throw the ball.
And will they maintain that balance? Time to find out. First down for the Giants as they pick up 12. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. Give the tackle there to Danielle Hunter.
I know you feel that.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it, because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Here's second and eight. Finds his tight end, Ingram. The reception good for seven. It's third down. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
On third down, Laird. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first. Able to get what they need to keep the drive going with a six-yard pickup on third down.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. Now a handoff here to his running back. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage. Second and 11. He's going to rifle one deep left side. It's caught inside the 25. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. That one good for 37 yards.
That was an excellent read right there. Saw cover one. That means it's just a single high safety. So you know if you throw the ball to the outside part of the field, help is going to be a little bit late getting there. And he puts one out there for a big-time completion.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. He'll look to throw. His throw caught at about the 5. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Scrimmage back at the 6. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, it's been how they turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get him in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
Second and goal from the 6 this time. And again, this time to the tailback. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on third and goal.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is it?
Defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
On third down, Barnes. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. It's about a 3-yard pickup there, but more importantly, they're still a few yards away here. It's now fourth down and goal. Such a long drive here. 3 points, that would be a disappointment, but I don't know if you can go for it here, can you?
Well, you know, the defense was really giving them a lot all the way downfield, and now they've stiffened. Forget that bend don't break. Now they don't even want to let them get a yard, do they? So in this spot, you remember what the coaches told us before the ball game? Any drive that ends with a kick is going to be okay with us, whether it's a punt, a field goal, or an extra point. Take the field goal right here.
A good drive gets him inside the five, but they could not punch it in.
And credit the defense, too. Make sure that that happens, because that was the old bend but don't break approach. Made sure they contained them when they absolutely had to and forced the field goal attempt that went through.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. And you see Dalvin Cook in the offense heading back out. And I'm wondering if maybe they don't go away from him on this drive a little bit. He's been great, but they haven't scored a lot of points.
I think they still have to show him as a threat. Make sure he touches it a few times. But as you pointed out, use him as a decoy a little bit and get the ball in the hands of some other people in order to put more points on the board. He's got a really
nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Khalil Mack in there yet again. What else is new? He continues to rewrite the record book in single-season sacks.
He's the NFL sack leader coming into the game, and now that's two more that he's added to his total.
He wants some separation from spot one and two in that sack category. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Cook. And nothing doing here as this time the run maybe gets him back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it. No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up. Now Trubisky on third and long, and Diggs has it. They get 15, but they still needed a little bit more. Fourth down.
Boy, they had a lot of real estate to make up there, but what a big-time play for them. Nice completion, excellent game. Now they're in fourth and manageable.
Just a little short, though, with that marker. The Vikings send out their punter. He's been one of their few bright spots so far. Averaging 50 yards a boot so far as this one's away. And problems spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. And New York set to take the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take...
It's caught inside the 25. And all the way down inside the 25 before he gets out of bounds.
That's a big-time pitch and catch right there. And partner, I remember the days when quarterbacks would try this. They were holding their breath. But nowadays, they're counting on their receiver to be just a little bit better than the defensive back when it's one-on-one and the ball's in the air like that.
So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And he's got it. Touchdown, Giants. Darius Slayton, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Giants are able to add on to their lead.
Brandon, my man, just one sentence for that one. Clinic.
And that's what they've done. They lead the league in points per game this season, but it's been quick strikeability, as we saw on that drive.
I think they're actually intimidating defenses because they're back on their heels right away, wondering where it's going to come from, how they're going to hit them. This group is well-organized, well-coached, and extremely confident in what they do.
The extra point up and good, and the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is taken at the three. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And you see Dalvin Cook and the offense heading back out. Now the ground game's been good, but they're losing here in the second quarter. Can they use that ground game maybe to work the air attack a little bit more?
I think so, because now you can throw play action off of being able to run the ball effectively. And oftentimes you might want to swing your back out of the backfield, get the ball in his hands in open space, and just don't get totally away from running it, because some of these runs now, they may pop bigger as the game goes along.
Yeah, they've been good with the run so far. They get 14 there. First down, Vikings.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Pick up! 180!
Hey, tight end's right. Watch tight end.
They run again on first down. Cook, and a good burst there, gets him seven up to midfield.
Oh, yeah. Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 12 yards there, first down, Vikings.
Yeah, they really needed to get something going, didn't they? They had punted on the last two possessions. The running game starting to come to the front for them, providing a nice pickup there to keep this drive going.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Come on, QB, come on. 24 is the mark.
Here's Madison running on first down. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run.
It's our time. It's our time.
Now they'll throw it with Trubisky. This one taken in by Olabisi Johnson. And he'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Trubisky now to throw on third down. And the grab by Croft. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. He hit his first. Now this one from 48 yards away. And that'll be off the crossbar and out. It's short. He couldn't get it there. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. And you just kind of get the sense that this team's been snake-bitten a little bit here. They just have not had anything go their way.
It's like they collectively walked under a ladder on their way into the stadium. What else could go wrong?
And New York set to take the field. They had to go a long way on their last drive to score the touchdown. This time, they get at least a little bit more of a cushion with field position.
I have to think that with this field position, after what they did on the last drive, they might want to take a shot right now and try and cut down the length of the drive.
So the missed field goal, and now they're in great shape. They'll start at the 38. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. He's going to rifle one deep left. That's caught at the 25. And he is down deep into Minnesota territory. A big play there for the Giants. 41 yards. What a first half this has been offensively. I mean, defensively, what do you do when you're getting torched like this?
Now, these receivers are absolutely wearing them out. So two thoughts come to mind. One, get some oxygen. You can fill up your lungs a little bit. And number two, talk to your guys up front. You need a pass rush to help slow them down.
So a big play as it gets them all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. They move the ball over 50 yards between this play and the last one.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
can they do here on second and goal? Three red zone trips so far have yielded two touchdowns and a field goal. They'll run it now out of the gun. And a little bit of space there takes it inside the five to the three. A pickup of four on first down. It'll be second and goal.
And a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He's trying to get his second touchdown already in the first half.
They had that one earlier. It was bidding for a second. On second down now, Walter. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. They give him 2 yards officially, and now it'll be third and goal. On third down, Walter. He's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up in the backfield. He lost two, and it brings up fourth. Defense didn't budge on third down. Now, what are we going to see on fourth?
We are soon to find out, but does this feel like old school football or what?
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
This is an old fashioned goal line stand. I know what I would call on offense. I would go for it. And I want some type of a play where my quarterback has a chance to run it or throw it. I don't just want one static play.
And his kick is right there. It's good. And that will extend the lead out to 24. No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20. Let's call it the 21-yard line. And you see Dalvin Cook and the offense heading back out. Now he's having himself a little bit of a banner game. His team right now, though, losing.
Needs a little bit of help. And I kind of equate it to a basketball game where you have the big score. And sometimes your strategy is, okay, he can go ahead and have all of his points. Let's hold down everyone else, and that's the way you win the game. And right now, he needs everyone else to start scoring, quote-unquote, as he's been.
Yeah, and he's hoping to keep it close so maybe they can keep it on the ground, not start to go through the air as much. Throwing on second down, Trubisky. He's got Smith here, and he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. O'Shane Zimenez, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
The Vikings send out their punter. He's been terrific so far. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And he fields it cleanly. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, given 15. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Here again comes the captain of this offense, leading his crew back out there now. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number 2 here in the second quarter. They'll try and start this drive in the air. He's going to rifle one deep. It's caught inside the 25. It's a big-time play there for the G-men. 43 yards. What a game it's been for this duo.
They remind me of a good comedy team. They know how to play off of each other so well. No matter how one riffs, the other's right there to pick them up, and they are shredding them in this ballgame.
So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. They'll look to throw here. And nearly picked it off. He had a chance to come down with that in the end zone, but it'll wind up just being incomplete. This secondary has been roasted in this first half, and they get a measure of revenge there. Nice play on the deep ball.
Yeah, they're going to need a few more plays like that in order to get their confidence fully back, but that's one step in the proper direction.
And able to fight forward inside the 15 to the 13. 8 yards on the run there, and that leaves them with third and just a couple. On third down, Laird. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. It's a gain of 6 as they're able to convert, and now it's first and goal. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with 2 ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And his kick here is good. And that will do it for this first half. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thank you very much. More from you two in a minute, but first, let's take a spin around the NFL and see what's going on here in week number 10. We'll begin up at legendary Lambeau Field in Green Bay, and it's the Packers who have the lead in that one. Aaron Rodgers with 2 touchdown passes. From there, we move to Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City to see what's going on with the Chiefs. And they've got the lead in that ball game over the 49ers as that one's gone to the half. Patrick Mahomes looking good. 2 touchdown passes. Lastly, let's get out to Jacksonville. See what's happening with the Jaguars at TIAA Bank Field. And as you see, they are currently all tied with the visiting Redskins. Meanwhile, our game has been a boat race. Very one-sided to this point. And for the call of the second half, let's get it back to our commentating team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you. And we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Out come the Vikings. They'll have it first on offense as we begin the third. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. Here's Trubisky. Open man is born. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down. That is catch number 300 now for his NFL career. Now Trubisky, and that will be incomplete.
Well, touch and time are critical for those types of throws. He put a lot of zip on that one. Needed just a little bit more finesse trying to get it to his back.
The Vikings send out their punter as they're forced to kick for the 6th time today. This is taken at the 23. A 46-yard boot, but just 36 following a pretty decent return of 10 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. Here's the Giants offense now getting set to start the 3rd quarter. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, Let's take control right away. Defense. We got the lead. Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see what the offense gets done.
So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they'll march off another 15 against your squad.
And now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. They'll keep it on the ground. Laird. They follow up the gain of 5 by only getting 1 there on second down.
Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
They'll drop the throw. Quickly here, and that's complete. Now the ball comes loose, and the Vikings pick up the football. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards.
We got four.
Another tote for the workhorse this afternoon. It's Cook. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. On 2nd and 9, Trubisky. And this is Cook with a grab. 17 yards, first down, Vikings.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Check, watch 54. Hey, let's get in them holes.
Trubisky now off the bootleg. Pressure comes and Trubisky goes down. Dexter Lawrence able to record his 5th sack of the season.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness of that defensive line is eating them alive.
And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's 2nd and 20. Now Cook, he's got it off the draw. He'll get 3, but it leaves him with a big hole here on 3rd and very long. These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on 3rd down. Now a 3rd down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
We're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. The Vikings send out their punter as he's on here to punt it away. And this one hits at the 3 and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. Yeah, the Giants ready to come out now. And last time, the fumble, the turnover. Now, they still have the lead, but I don't think coaches care. The turnovers will bother them no matter what the scoreboard says.
If that's the relief, that you still have the lead. But coaches look at what if and what it should be. Turning the ball over when they've got a chance to score more points and increase the lead, that's what's going to affect them.
And they're also thinking to future weeks, maybe when the game's closer, right?
No doubt about it. You want to clean up everything. Let's just be honest about it. They want everything to be perfect at all times. They don't want to give up anything that's going to hurt their team.
And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
This quarterback now over 300 yards now for the game, and time to improve on that as he's got a first and 10. They'll set up to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Danielle Hunter in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback, because he had no chance to block him.
Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Back to throw. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. They'll look to throw. He's going to rifle one deep left side. Looks to throw, fires right side. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down.
Finally, a good play there defensively on the deep ball. The secondary has had its struggles this entire game. Offensively, they've had their way with them.
Here's Riley Dixon now as he's on to punt for New York. A big boot that time, 57 yards the official distance. And the Vikings will take over here, first and 10. The Vikings offense now heading out to take over. And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because three straight drives have ended with them punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
180! 54! Get that quarterback at all costs!
They start the drive with Cook. And not a whole lot to speak of there as they'll bring him down shy of the 20. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stopped that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
You must be dreaming.
Throwing on second and 8, Trubisky. Now Trubisky lost the football, and the Giants have it. It's picked up, and this is taken into the end zone. A fumble recovery and a Giants touchdown. So the big fella gets on the scoreboard with a return for a touchdown. Good thing he didn't have to go too far, though.
You know the trainers were very happy about that. Imagine having to go get him in the end zone, escort him to the bench, and give him the oxygen. They were loving the fact that he got in without having to run very far.
The try here for the extra point. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for 6. So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. And that last possession, really a gut punch. You seemingly had it working. You were in the midst of a very strong drive, then suddenly the fumble, and you're watching the back of a defender's jersey as he brings it all the way in the other direction.
There's not much more I can add to that. I thought you summarized it perfectly, partner. You've just got to regroup and start putting another drive together. That's all you can do.
Ready?
Let's get it together, defense. Let's get it together.
Here's Cook as they begin on the ground. And not much to speak. A one-yard gain up to the 26.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine.
Watch 54. Watch the
slant. Again, it's Cook. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. It's a gain of 11 as the Vikings pick up the first.
Man, these guys may not win this ball game, but you certainly can't fault the effort of this man here today. He's been a real thorn in their sides all afternoon. And that last carry puts him over the 100-yard mark.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now a give running right, it's Cook. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll wind up being a loss of two, and that'll make it second and 12.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Behind the line of scrimmage. He lost two there, and it's third down.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that, got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Third and 15 here after the first and second down plays went in the wrong direction. From the shotgun is Trubisky. That's to Cook out of the backfield. And he'll only get this to about the 44 as they stop him short of the line to gain. They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
That's certainly playing down in distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
The Vikings send out their punter as he'll come on to kick this one away. And this one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Giant offense now as they get ready to take over here. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to fire one deep up. And got his man complete. Past the 20. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. A big play there. With touchdown number 20 on the year as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. One play, 80 yards. Pretty easy drive to recap.
It certainly is, but not so easy to execute. Starting on your own 20, you want something to kickstart your drive and get it off to a nice start.
They went for the whole thing and got it. That's a great way to send a message to the opposing team.
Extra point attempt to follow here. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Those are the ones the offensive coordinators dream about. One play drives from that distance. What an effort. It results in the touchdown. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And you see Dalvin Cook in the offense heading back out. He is knocking on the door for 100 yards in this ball game.
And it's so important. It doesn't seem like it's that big of a deal. Just short of it, a little bit over. A little bit over feels better to everyone. Offensive line, running back, team totals, just something magical about breaking that barrier.
And he's right there on the doorstep now.
Here we go, D. Here I come again.
On first and 10, it's Trubisky. That one into the hands of Thielen, complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That'll go as a pickup of 32 on the catch and run.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Now it's Trubisky. Now Trubisky lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15.
57.
Now Cook. And forget that 100-yard rushing game, at least for the moment, as he'll lose yardage here and fall back under the century mark for the game.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Third and 15 here after the first and second down plays went in the wrong direction. Off the play fake, here's Trubisky. And he's going to go down. They sack him back at the 42.
It's been a tough one all game long for this offensive line. They're already down big, and now you know they're just going to come after the quarterback in a big way, don't you?
Yeah, they just can't get out of their own way right now. It's created an avalanche, and an avalanche is coming right on top of them. The Vikings send out their punter as he's on to kick it away.
The Lions
comes this field general once more, leading his offense back onto the field. He has been consistent, hasn't he? He played well in the first quarter, good second quarter, and now continuing that here in the third.
And that's the word that they're always seeking from the guy taking the snaps, is consistency. Taking care of the ball, making sure it gets to the right people, no errors, right? Not turning it over, and just doing all the right things. That's leadership, and it inspires confidence in a team.
Yeah, been a good leadership and a good distributor.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
They'll keep it on the ground. Laird, and they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. On play action, they'll throw. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in. Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up second and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
Go.
He'll drop to throw. He'll complete this to Ingram, his tight end. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 10 yards, good for a Giant first down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
This quarterback now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. And to give this time to the tailback. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
Here's 2nd and 8. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And he will take it on in for a Giant touchdown. A big play there. His 21st touchdown of the season as his guys continue to pour it on.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his 2nd touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. No going for 2. They'll kick the point after. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And it was polished off by a Giants touchdown. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is, just what you said, you've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. Now Trubisky on first down. It's caught. Smith. And from the 25, they work this to the 29. A gain of 4. That throw good for 4. It's 2nd down.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
On 2nd down, it's Cook. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. Play action. It's Trubisky. And he's able to find Diggs. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants 39. Back in the first quarter, you said it. They need to avoid the big play, but he just got a big one right there.
You can't relax. You know, we talked about in the first quarter, but as the game progresses, still opportunities, and he took advantage of one there.
So the drive takes him into Giants territory now, first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Throwing here, Trubisky. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Khalil Mack, my goodness, make that now 5 sacks for him in this ball game. Really, really turning in an incredible performance. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack.
Let's go.
On the ground, it's Cook. Able to pick up a healthy chunk of yards, 7-yard gain, but a tough third and 9 upcoming.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
They need to get to the 29 if they want to pick up a first here on third down. Out of the gun, Trubisky. Got the connection here to Bourne. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
All that practice time came to fruition on that play. All those timing routes that they work on through training camp, OTAs, mini camp, and just regular season, they got it done on that one. An outcut, ball was delivered, and picked up the completion.
And this won't get there. Won't be online either. It's no good. Off to the right, and this score will stay right where it is.
NFL kickers nowadays, they make things look so easy. 2 out of 3, and this is not an easy kick.
Yeah, 20 years ago, you get where he was in that 50 range, maybe a little over, and it's a big kick, but now we just, if they leave it short, you're like, whoa, what happened? And that's what we have here.
Yeah, you're right. 20 years ago, we were saying run some more plays and get closer. Now we think they're definitely within range, and you're exactly right. When it comes up short, there has to be something that went wrong because they have plenty of leg.
Good starting field position for the New York Giants here as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 10 yards, good for a Giant first down. And he's certainly been a huge factor in this when he's got the 2 touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him, double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
He certainly looks to be in that groove right now. This quarterback now a perfect 8 for 8 to start the second half. Not bad. First and 10. He'll look to throw. Finds his tight end, Ingram. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at 1 yard. That last catch short of the marker by just 1 yard leaves him with a very manageable 2nd and 1. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports.
Four.
second and one. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 30. So first and 10 now from the 30.
I can't believe they let you play. I can't believe they even let you play.
And he'll give it here to his running back. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7. Charles, you said earlier this defense is probably going to need to hold these guys right around 20 or under that if they were going to have a chance. It was evident pretty early on that wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, they left 20 behind a long time ago in this game, didn't they? It looks like they're headed towards a big, big number. But 20 was the threshold because that kept them in the ball game and kept the pressure off of their own offense.
They'll keep it on the ground. Laird, he's able to get 6. A nice pickup down to the 21. And he's going to be stopped just short of the first down marker at the Vikings 21.
That's a gain of 6. Brings up third and
the Giants on third down. They've converted 6 times and could use a 7th here. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. Now a handoff here to his running back. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know, well-conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
And goal. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here, and that'll bring up a 2nd and goal.
Brent, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the 4th quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Moved back to the 10. They'll try on 2nd and goal here. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground.
Wow. That ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. Well, they've been so good on third down all day long. Can they convert another here on 3rd and goal? They'll try to run this one in. No gain on the play that time. So a big stop, and it's going to leave them with a 4th and goal.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
So out comes the field goal team once more. This will be just a 21-yard attempt. And his kick is good. And they're sitting pretty now as the lead grows even further. So it's 3 more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the 4th.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This fielded at the 2. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line.
Here we go.
Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field. And last time out, another missed field goal. So maybe their confidence wavering a little bit right now in the kicking game.
And I'm with you on that. I think at this stage, they'd love to not run him back out there in a tough situation. But let's face it, they may have to. So right now, the head coach is talking to the offense coordinator and saying, call this game like we're going to put it in the end zone. Let's try and take the field goal out of it.
first down. Trubisky, nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Dexter Lawrence able to record his fifth sack of the season.
That right now, that's a defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
So after the sack here, second and 14. Now Trubisky. And he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first. And it's third down now. Another incompletion. You know, it's a wonder he's still moving around back there the number of times he's been sacked.
Yeah, he's staying out there, isn't he? And you don't think about it much in a game like this, but he's showing incredible leadership. Still competing, still fighting, not taking himself out of a ball game that appears lost.
Trubisky will throw, and Diggs has it. And he will be marked down short of the first as they get to him at the 29. They pick up 10, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
The Vikings send out their punter as he's on here to punt it away. And this will be taken at the 13. A terrific return. 30 yards all in all. And it'll be Giant football first and 10. Set to take the field. And Charles, we are in the midst of a very one-sided affair. I think this is where you and I have to fill a little bit. You want to regale us with old stories of your childhood in New Paltz, New York?
I don't think anyone wants to hear that, but this is a perfect time for us to start listing MVP candidates, right?
Right.
The best teams we've seen so far this year, the best games that we've called thus far, how we anticipate the season unfolding. We can go in so many different directions because the game certainly not taking us there.
Oh, I hear the remotes clicking off right now. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. This offense has had a lot to like in this game. I don't know that last play, though, is going to make the highlight reel.
It's not going to make the highlight reel, but it will be the focus of the film session that the team has to sit through. I've sat through those before. Never any fun. You're always excited about your good plays. And they actually fast forward through those. All right, that was good. All right, great. They get to the bad ones and really illuminate them. Not cool.
Second and 13. Finding Sterling Shepard for his first catch. And they've got it well across midfield down to the 40 before it's all said and done. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up in a different era, and we think about sportsmanship and all that. Other people think about fantasy points and getting their numbers. That's all they care about right now.
From their own 40 to the other 40. The gain of 20 leads to first and 10.
They're not ready for this, man. They're not ready for this. They still playing soccer.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he can even get started. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that'll make this a second and 13.
I have zero rooting interest in either team in this game. I only want a good game. But with all the offense we've seen from them tonight, it's kind of nice to see the defense step up and make a big play.
Yeah, I was wondering if they were ever going to get him in the backfield. Nice to see him get a stop.
He's tired of me. He's tired of us.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And his throw is incomplete. There to knock that one away defensively, Eric Kendricks.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
And they'll get him down at the 34, and he's going to be short of the first by a few yards.
Give him 9 on the carry, but it's not enough, and it'll be fourth down.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
Fourth down, so Pat Shurmur trots out the field goal unit. On the left hash, officially it's called a 51-yard attempt. It's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short. No good. And this score will stay right where it is. Mitchell Trubisky on his way out, the subject of our player's spotlight.
What can they do now, Charles, to make sure this highlight montage doesn't continue to show more pressure and pressure and pressure?
You feel like it always comes back to leverage, don't you? Who is going to win that battle of the offensive and defensive lines? Low man wins, we talk about that, but we think about it in a running game. Well, guess what? The same thing happens when you're trying to pass protect. Are you low? Are you balanced? Are you in a position where the pass rush won't bowl you over on their way back to the quarterback? They've got to reestablish that in order to try and keep their man upright.
Because they have been bowled over a lot so far in this one.
They'll throw on first down with Trubisky toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
Tight end Irv Smith, the intended receiver.
And that'll bring up second down.
Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Here now is second and 10, again from the 41.
Here's Trubisky, setting up the screen for Cook.
And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. It's a gain of 16, and the Vikings have the first down as well.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Looking to throw, Trubisky on first down. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Khalil Mack in there to get him again. That is sack number 6, one off the NFL record of 7.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front, nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Now Trubisky to throw. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. Give them 5 on the screen play, and that'll set up a third down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
And five in the secondary now for the Giants on third down. From the gun, it's a give to Cook. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
You know, it's become cliche, but we have seen it and observed it. When runners have days like what we're seeing right now, they often take their offensive linemen out for steaks afterwards, don't they? They all go buy them dinner. But after a play like that, he might reduce him, might go to the corner and just grab a hot dog or two, huh?
Hey, I mean, they've still been blocking for him well in this game. They don't get one mulligan up front.
Okay, so what we're saying then is we're going petit filet instead of porterhouse.
Eight
How's
ounce.
That?
8 ounce is good.
All right, just checking. Keep playing.
The Giants offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. We find ourselves here in the midst of a one-sided affair. A lot of fill time down the stretch, Mr. Davis.
So we could talk about food because that is something that you and I
enjoy. We share that.
We enjoy our time at the table. So maybe the best steakhouses in the city, but in all seriousness, the performances that we've seen this year, we've seen a bunch of great ones. And it's going to be hard to parse who's going to win the MVP.
Yeah, it really is.
Is it going to be a runner? Is it going to be a thrower? Can a defender finally win it this season? Those are the things that we could probably discuss.
And collectively, this is about as dominant of a performance as you could have hoped for on both sides of the football.
Might have to put it number one for what we've seen this season.
Second and two. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. 10 yards, good for a Giant first down. And on that last play there, he's over 400 yards passing now.
You know what that generally means?
Success.
That, and it means you really didn't miss opportunities. Usually very accurate. The ball's getting to the right place. Guys are making yardage after the catch to help you out that way. I mean, the whole team has picked it up. And don't forget, that means the offensive line has had to pass protect pretty well, too. Yeah,
everyone dialed in. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Now a handoff here to his running back. Oh, he shifts past him. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
And he finds a man with a crossing route. 4 yards to pick up, first down. Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. And again, this time to the tailback. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. 13 yards, good for a Giant first down.
Brandon, sometimes it just comes down to the power of suggestion, because I know exactly what they said all week long. We're coming off the open week. We'll have the fresher legs in the fourth quarter, and they will wilt when we get to that point. And right now, it appears that they're thinking that exact thing.
Yeah, offensively, they had the bye last week. Defensively, did not. Is that really a big factor? Is that more talk during the week?
I think the more that you talk about it, the more that you emphasize it, the more sometimes it comes true for your team.
Now a play fake here on first down. And he's going to drop this out to his fullback. And he's going to get this inside the 30. First down for the Giants as they pick up 12.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in at this point. You can just go ahead and play.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old-school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. First down for the Giants as they pick up 12.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
On first down, Laird. And he loses the football a second time. And the Vikings pick up the football. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
They may have the edge on the scoreboard, but that hasn't made them pass it, has it? I mean, they dialed up a pretty good run blitz there. And Brandon, you know that all blitzes aren't just designed to get to the quarterback and the passer. Sometimes you're just trying to take away every gap, every hole that might be created in a running game, and they did it to perfection and caused a fumble there.
Took away the gaps, took away the holes, took away the football. And you see Dalvin Cook and the offense heading back out, and we have seen a decline in the numbers. Where does the fault lie? Just him? Maybe the guys up front? Combination?
Well, as you and I both know, it's almost always a collective deal. But in this case, I think maybe the offensive line got a little overconfident. They had blocked so well in the first half, picked up on what the defense was doing. I think we've seen an adjustment now that they have not picked up on.
So they need to determine if that knee was down before the ball was coughed up.
And they also wanted to make sure that the ball was possessed as they were going through, that the ball wasn't working its way free before the knee hit the ground.
Intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first. And it's third down now. They're going to look to throw. And give him another six. It's caught for a touchdown. And the blowout continues. So another score there. Often you talk about the three phases of the game: defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a fourth phase. That's the coaching. And he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
They are looking strong here in the fourth quarter. Now for the point after. Now, this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. Well, that drive started with not a whole lot of real estate in front of them. In plus territory, excellent field position. Two plays later, pay dirt. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This fielded at the two. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
What we got?
Hey. On first and 10, it's Trubisky. It's complete to Diggs. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. It's a gain of 16, and the Vikings have the first down as well.
So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. It's a gain of 11 as the Vikings pick up the first. It's been a remarkable day at the office for him running the football. Those yards just continue to pile well past 100.
And how about more than double-digit carries in the second half alone? That's what you want as a runner, because you've got to prove to your offensive line that you're going to be as tough as they are. They don't rotate in and out on every play. Running backs often do, so those who can stay out there with their offensive linemen, those are the guys they really value.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. From midfield now, here's Trubisky. He's got Smith here. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 46. Khalil Mack in there for the 7th time in this game alone. And that ties him with the late Derek Thomas for the most sacks ever in a single game.
Exactly what they were looking for. They've been giving up yardage. They've been letting them drive right downfield, but they got a sack right there. How about that for a little bit of revenge?
Let's see what they draw up here. 3rd and long following the sack of Trubisky. From the shotgun is Trubisky. Complete. Smith has it. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be 4th down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. Trubisky and the troops staying out there. They will go for it. Running for it. Here's Cook. And he's not even going to come close to picking up the first. They stop him right at the line of scrimmage. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Giants are going to take over in great field position. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
And they'll indeed take a knee. And they take a knee. But Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle it.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Giants, the win will help them keep pace in the playoff race as they move to 6-3 on the year. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Detroit Lions. Meanwhile, for Minnesota, the loss will drop them to 6-3 now on the year. And they'll try and turn things around next week as they have a date at MetLife Stadium with the New York Jets. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gauden, saying so long, everybody.